Hey everybody, I'm Matt Camp. NXT New Year's Evil began with Dexter Lumis flipping the switch on his own brand of chaos. And when it was all said and done, some superstars began 2021 on a high note, while others would have preferred to turn back the clock. Let's examine all the fallout in this week's NXT Injury Report. Kyle O'Reilly was hoping the second time was the charm when he faced Finn Balor for the NXT Championship, 3 months after their first meeting when he came up just short at NXT TakeOver 31. Much like their first encounter, it was another hard-hitting and wince-inducing battle of strikes and submissions. But this time, it was Balor targeting O'Reilly's jaw. No doubt looking for some payback for O'Reilly breaking Balor's jaw in three places. The NXT champion retained his title when he locked on a devastating abdominal stretch crossface submission, leaving O'Reilly no choice but to tap out. After the match, it was reported both men were on their way to the hospital, O'Reilly to have his jaw x-rayed and Finn to get his arm checked out. While we have no further update on either man, O'Reilly tweeted, "Well, Finn, you did what you said you were going to do. You made me suffer, and you beat me. But you didn't break me. At least not like I broke you." Rhea Ripley and Raquel Gonzalez gave us a glass-shattering tour of the Capitol Wrestling Center during their brutal Last Woman Standing match, and Dakota Kai took an involuntary residence in a locker. The latest chapter between these two powerhouses came to a close when Gonzalez powerbombed Ripley through the stage for a 10 count. Both Ripley and Gonzalez came out of the match with bruises and contusions, so neither is medically cleared, and both are considered day-to-day. Timothy Thatcher was scheduled to face Tommaso Ciampa in the Fight Pit at New Year's Evil, but General Manager William Regal announced that after conferring with medical staff, Thatcher suffered a minor injury while training, and due to the brutal nature of the match, Thatcher could not be cleared. However, with proper rehab, Thatcher should be back in action soon, and when he's healed, Thatcher and Ciampa will settle their differences in the Fight Pit. Katrina Cortez had the unfortunate luck of being Xia Li's first opponent, following weeks of Li's intense training. A new look and far more vicious approach for Li was on full display in a dominating victory that culminated with a powerful spin kick to Cortez's face. It should come as no surprise that Cortez has facial bruising and a possible orbital bone injury, so she is not medically cleared. Austin Theory and The Way were out to celebrate the end of Johnny Gargano's championship curse, only to be interrupted by Shotzi Blackheart. When Theory went to confront Blackheart, he was struck in the groin with a projectile from her tank. Later, Theory tried to interject himself in the mixed tag match, only for Kushida to drop toehold Gargano headfirst into Theory's already damaged groin. To add insult to injury, Kushida would pin the North American champion. Theory does have a groin injury, but is expected to be okay, and is cleared as symptoms allow. Ouch. Next week, we kick off the 2021 Dusty Rhodes Tag Team Classic, with Breezango facing Undisputed Era, and Ever-Eyes taking on the Grizzled Young Veterans. Catch it all on USA Network next Wednesday at 8, 7 Central.